Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Caboose bringing you another Mortal Kombat movie video. And today what I got for you guys here is some official character posters, the character designs being revealed for the Mortal Kombat movie, including your boy Sub-Zero. Before we get into everything, I wanted to ask you guys, of course, if at any point you enjoy the video, if you could consider leaving a like rating on it, it would show your support. And I would really appreciate it. So if you enjoy the video at any point, or if you're hyped for the Mortal Kombat movie, then a like rating on the video would be appreciated. And also, if you guys are looking forward to the Mortal Kombat movie, well then I got you covered. I've been making videos on the news and updates for the film, providing you guys all the information about the Mortal Kombat movie. We'll definitely be doing a reaction to the trailer tomorrow. And we'll be doing some fun stuff when the movie launches in April. If that sounds good to you, well then if you'd like to, you can subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to be immediately notified when a video goes live. And with that said, let's talk about this. The reason I'm doing this video right now is because it's 11:18 a.m. and they've been doing this trend where they're releasing a new character poster like every hour. I think they just tweeted out the Scorpion poster. I think, because I got a notification for it on my phone because I have the notifications for the Mortal Kombat movie Twitter page on, but I want to go through what we've seen already and then we'll react together to the Scorpion one. So first up, we got Sub-Zero looking so sick. Like, oh my God, this design is incredible. I think it's very MKX inspired. You can kind of see that it's getting that vibe. You know, it's coming from the more MKX looking design of Sub-Zero. The only thing that I'm not the biggest fan of, I don't hate it, but the only thing I'm not the biggest fan of with all the designs that we see here is that there isn't too much color on the actual suit. Now you can get the blue, you know it's Sub-Zero because of that, through the eyes, through the ice, of course the sword that he's got there, but on the actual suit, it's a bit more of a muted blue, a bit more of a black kind of color that he's wearing. So we'll see how it looks in motion in the film, but in terms of just the aesthetic, it's incredible. Like, this design is amazing. And of course, Joe Taslim playing Sub-Zero, gonna kill it. I can't wait to see him in the film. Then we got Tadanobu Asano, I believe it's pronounced, playing Raiden. Oh my God, this design also looking sick. Love the hat, love the staff, the electricity that's flowing there, the white eyes. They're nailing this. They are nailing this. I'm a big fan of this design. Then we got, I believe it's Shin Han playing Shang Tsung, and this is perfect. Like, this design is literally perfect. He almost kind of looks like Kari Tagawa a little bit, which is what makes it as good as it is. I can't wait to see this in motion. Love the soles in the hand there. That is so good. And the costume as well. It's so, so cool. I can't wait. I'm actually getting really excited for this movie now. Then we got Ludi Lin, Liu Kang. And I mean, come on. What can't I say about this guy already that people haven't said from when we got the first look of the movie through EW? I mean, he looks so good as this character. It's a perfect fit. And seeing him and Kung Lao, who we'll get to in a second, is going to be great to see in live action. The Shaolin monks in live action is going to be really exciting. Speaking of the Shaolin monks, just like I said, Kung Lao's design was also revealed through one of these character posters, I believe played by Max Huang, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. I'm so sorry if I'm pronouncing any of these names incorrectly, but either way, super excited. I love this design as well. The hat looks perfect. He looks straight, pretty much ripped right out of the game and put into the film. This is one of the most accurate designs that we got for the characters that we've seen through all of these posters. We got Macaude Brooks playing Jax. Loving this design as well. I know people, I understand the meme, okay? I know what you're gonna say. Just backspace your comment, all right? Enough. The meme is dead. But overall, really like the design. The arms look sick here. I wonder if they're going to go into the origin and if it'll actually be Ermac who's done it in this movie as well. That would be a sick way to expand the universe a little more and maybe tease a Mortal Kombat 2 where we can see characters like Ermac show up. I don't know. We'll see. Loving this though. Then we got Jessica McNamee. Again, I'm so sorry about the names. She's playing Sonya Blade. Looking good, looking badass as ever. And I mean, there's really not too much you can get wrong here with Sonya Blade's design. So they've done a good job. I just wonder if she's gonna have the rings, the projectiles, as one of the abilities in the movie. Then there's Josh Lawson. That is a hard name to say 10 times fast. Playing Kano. Looking good. I'm 50-50 on this design because I want the Full Metal Eye. That is Kano to me. But I have seen some people speculate that maybe these cuts, whatever he's got here, maybe at some point in the movie, it's going to be like fully ripped off flesh and you're going to see the metal eye revealed and it's underneath some of those cuts that he has. If they do something like that, okay, that's a cool setup. That's a nice payoff. But if it's just that he has the cybernetic eye and it's a red eye and that's it, I don't know. That's a bit of a missed opportunity in my opinion. But at the end of the day, it's how the character is portrayed in terms of just full-on characterization beyond just what their design is. So I'm looking forward to seeing what this actor does with the character of Kano. Then there's Cece Stringer, I believe, as Melina. And I think there's going to be some people who aren't the biggest fan of this design because, you know, you don't immediately recognize it to be Melina if there weren't a Psy there. So I'm not sure how people are going to feel about this. But we'll see if they're going to do something like maybe she opens up the mouth and you see all the teeth and all that. Maybe something like that will happen in the movie. Not entirely sure. And I also wonder, so is she playing Katana as well? What's happening there? How are they going to tackle the fact that she is, of course, kind of a clone of Katana? And then there's Cole Young. The one and only Cole Young. Brand new character to the Mortal Kombat movie. There's really not much going on here. He's got the little dragon birthmark thing that we heard about from the EW article. I'm not sure what else to really say. I don't know if this character is going to have powers or abilities or what exactly is being hinted at in terms of the character's heritage, but I guess we'll see. I don't know. I don't want to complain too much because everything I've seen besides this Cole Young character looks incredible. So I want to have faith that they know what they're doing with this movie. And with that, I'm just gonna go in with an open mind and see how this all plays out. I don't want to be too critical until I've seen the movie. Okay, oh my God. Okay, I am just now finally, holy smokes. I am finally just now seeing this. Hiroyuki Sanada, I believe it's pronounced, playing Scorpion, looking badass. Holy smokes, this design is ridiculous. I love it. Oh my God. The fire, you know, he's got the spear in his hands, the mask, the hood is up. You can see the yellow in there, which I really like. I think it's a little muted, kind of similar to Sub-Zero, but it's more so of, like, you can see it there more than you can in the Sub-Zero design and all the eyes and everything. This is everything with Sub-Zero and Scorpion. If they nail that, I'll be happy with this movie. Even if everything else isn't as great or they don't do a great job with it, if there's enough Scorpion and Sub-Zero and they do a good job with that element, I'm all in on this Mortal Kombat movie and I want to see some more of it. This looks incredible. And that's it. That is all the character posters that we got for the Mortal Kombat movie. The trailer drops tomorrow at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. That is noon Eastern. You're going to see my reaction right here on this channel, so you guys better be prepared for it. And with all that said, I want to kick it to you guys. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. First of all, what do you think about all the character posters that we got for the Mortal Kombat movie, and which character design do you think looks the best? For me, it's gotta be this guy. It's gotta be this guy. I don't know. I want to know what you guys have to say in the comments below. Sound off in the comments. And of course, if you enjoyed today's video, if you could consider leaving a like rating on it, it would show your support and I would really appreciate it. I'm Caboose, and you can click on screen to make your way to one of the other videos on the channel, or you can click my logo to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. You can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Those links are going to be in the description. Drop a like if you enjoyed, leave a comment if you have an opinion, and subscribe if you're new. See you guys later.